Good morning, children. How are you all? Children, I hope you all are fit and fine. So children, today's our topic is fertilization and implantation. Children, the fertilization and implantation is very, very much important in the process of sexual reproduction. Because children, we know the fertilization happens only if the ovum and the sperms are transported simultaneously. So all the copulations do not lead to fertilization and pregnancy. A sperm contacts with the zona pellucida layer of the ovum and it induces the changes in the membrane that blocks the entry of the additional sperm to the ovum. And then the secretion of the acrosome, which helps the sperm to enter the egg cytoplasma via the zona pellucida layer and the plasma membrane. Children, we know the structure of the sperm, in which the first part is the head part, in which the acrosomes are present, the middle part in which the mitochondria is present to provide the energy to the sperm, and the last part is the tail part which provide the motility to the sperm. So children, this causes the second meiotic division of the secondary oocyte and to form the ovum, or we can say that the secondary polar body is formed. Children, the haploid nuclei of the sperm and the ovum fuse together to form a diploid zygote. That the fertilization means the fusion of this male and female gamete is called the fertilization. And then the cell is formed, which is called the zygote. Children, you can see the cleavage of the zygote means the mitosis division. Mitotic divisions are undergoes into the zygote. It means the cleavage start as it moves through the isthmus towards the uterus and to form 2-celled, then 4-celled, then 8-celled, 16-cell stage, and after that 16 daughter cell stage is called the blastomeres. And this stage is called the blastocyst. Children, the embryo with the 8 to 16 blastomere is called the morula. And morula continues to divide and transform into the blastocyst. So children, this is the type of the mitotic division in the zygote after the fertilization period. So children, in the blastocyst, what happens? The blastomeres are arranged in a outer layer and inner cell mass, which attached to the trophoblast. Then the trophoblast layer gives nourishment to the inner cell mass, and also it gets the attached to the endometrium. We know the endometrium is the innermost lining of the uterus, where is this trophoblast is attached. Children, the inner cell mass gets differentiated to 3 germs layer. In the 3 germ layer, the outermost germ layer is called the ectoderm, the middle layer is called the mesoderm, and the innermost layer, which is called the endoderm. So that this three layered structure, you can see in this diagram, there is a cross section of the blastula, the cross section of the gastrula. So that this three germ cell layer is called the gastrulation, and then form the embryo. children, you can see the diagram of the endometrium. This is the innermost layer of the uterus and then the uterine cavity. What happens after the attachment? The uterine cells divide rapidly and cover the blastocyst. As a result, the blastocyst becomes embedded into the endometrium. You can see easily in this first diagram, you can see the uterine mucosa cells and the blastocyst which start digest the uterine mucosa. And in this second diagram, there is embedded, these blastocyst is embedded in the wall of the endometrium completely. And this completely embedded structure of the blastocyst into the endometrium, which called the implantation, so that into the endometrium grows over the surrounded the embryo, and this stage is called the implantation, which is very much important for the pregnancy and embryo development. So hope children, this topic is clear to you. Today you should write down the notes of fertilization and implantation from your book. Thank you children.